accolades associated with his name. But to be very short and sweet, I can say that it is most enlightening to know that he is a peer reviewer for SCEI Index Journal, International Journal of Ophthalmology. So that is a great achievement. And of course, he is the head of department of Ahalya School of Optometry in Palakkad, and he's had the best humanitarian award in the SPI Optics and Photonics conference at San Diego in 2013. Go ahead, please.
Thank you very much. Before I start my talk, I thought I will. How many of you are doing rosecap practice? No? RGP? Soft lenses? Okay, fine. Why I'm asking you this question is it would be easier if you know the RGP lens practice. But anyway, I have made my presentation in such a way that it reaches you, and followed by Jyoti ma'am's case presentation will be there on a rosecap, and followed by tomorrow and day after tomorrow's wet lab. So these four, my talk, Jyoti ma'am's talk, and followed by two wet lab sessions tomorrow, will definitely make you to go and practice rosecap in your clinics. Yes ma'am?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, that's the target we had kept actually. So, good morning to all. I thank AUSC for giving me the opportunity to give a talk to the ophthalmologists present here. My talk is on fitting the irregular cornea with rosecap lenses. Yeah. We know the causes of irregular corneas are mainly keratoconus, poor corneal injuries, post-corneal tear repairs, post-LASIK, post-PK. Any of these conditions which does cause irregular scarring of the cornea, and then vision will be affected, you cannot correct with the spectacles. So what are the options we have to correct this? So spectacles, poor vision, contact lenses, there are soft lenses, still poor vision, hard lenses, poor oxygen permeability, sorry, and rigid permeable lenses are there, fitting is very tough, you will have the chair time you spend on RGP lenses is very high for this. And then combined lens systems are also there. There are so many other keratoconus design lenses are there, but what I am going to talk is about rosecap family of lenses, which I find it is very easy to fit, easy to learn. The concept is very simple also. So if you go to the rosecap lenses, they have four designs are there. Rosecap 2, which is a regular routine one, then comes Rosecap 2 nipple cone. The small cones where the diameter of the cone is too small, you can go for this trial set. Then irregular corneas like these conditions, keratoglobus, post-LASIK, post-DAS, irregular corneas, you can use this trial set. And then Rosecap is having a separate post-DAS PK, post-PK trial sets also. So depending on your condition, you can you can select the trial kit. Even if you don't have all, you can start with Rosecap 2. The simple, the first one. So this will have, what are these lenses actually? The Rosecap is a unique keratoconus lens design with complex computer generated peripheral curves. I always feel, so I have fitted since 1994 from LVPI, I have been fitting RGP lenses. But the idea, I didn't get it. I envy Dr. Paul Rose because he got the idea. What did he do? He generated a computer generated peripheral curves. He divided the base curve and peripheral curves separately and then started fitting. That made fitting easy. So that is why you see in Rosecap 85% first fit success. The first fit itself, yeah, you will hit 6-6 vision. So the other 15% is basically, you know, trying for the patient's comfort, whether it's a tight fit or a loose fit and all. So Rosecap, there are trial sets are available in each case. So 26 lenses are available in Rosecap 2, nipple cone trial set 25 lenses, Rosecap 2 IC 14 lenses, Rosecap 2 post-draft 22 lenses. with various diameter base cow ranges, diameter ranges with any power and edge lift. There are three types of edge lift: standard, standard flat, and standard steep. There are three types of edge lifts are there. So how do we do Roscale fitting assessment? These are the six things which are important. First, you have to select the initial base curve. Then you have to assess the central fit. Then you have to assess the peripheral fit. Then assess the diameter, do over refraction, and correct for residual astigmatism and prescribe the lenses. And how is it different from regular RGB lens fitting? As I was telling you earlier, all these are interlinked in an RGB, whereas in Roscale it's independent. That's when the practice is very easy. You just need to have a trial kit, that's all. You can start doing Roscale practice. So how do we do base curve selection? Normally it is 0.2 to 0.3 mm steeper on the mean K reading. On a mean K reading, you go 0.2 to 0.3 mm steeper and fit the lens. So then what will happen? You will have to assess the central fit, how the fit is. To evaluate the central fit immediately after blink, when the lens is centered. A light feather touch at the apex of the cone is desired. Like when you fit a lens, this is a cone, this is a cornea, it should have a central touch like this. Not full flat touch, central mild touch. There are some practitioners which prefer, you know, mild apical clearance also. So that depends on your, you know, once you start fitting the lenses, you will know which is comfortable for the patient. So these are the few fluorescein patterns where, you know, optimum fit immediately after the blink. You can see here, this is a lens low riding and this is good central fit but loose pelvis. You see the huge fluorescein pattern at the edges of the lens. This shows that, you know, it is the edge is very loose, you need to steepen it. Here if you see, good fit peripherally also. So similarly for Roscale to NC, all the varieties of lenses, the fluorescein patterns are given. In fact, in the Roscale trial kit itself, when you order, the company provides all these things actually. You can see how a loose fit will be, how a central fit, how a flat fit. The company itself provides all these things. Then you have to assess the peripheral fit. So once the optimum central fit is achieved, assess edge lift. Look for even fluorescein pattern of 0.5 to 0.7 mm. Order increased or decreased edge lift accordingly. What am I talking about? See, you can see in this picture, this shows optimum edge lift will give a fluorescein band of 0.5 to 0.7 mm with no excessive lift or peripheral seal at any point. You see here the fluorescein pattern is excess here. So this is a flat fit where you need to steep fit. As I told you, there are three types of designs are there: standard edge lift, standard steep, standard flat. So if you find the fluorescein pattern in your trial lens like this, you will have to go for a little standard steep edge lift value. The vice versa, you see the fluorescein pattern at the edge is very minimal here, so it is very tight, so you have to go for a standard flat edge lift. So here everything is base curve is separate, edge clearance, it is separate.
5 minutes.
Yeah, and you can see these are the edge lifts available: standard lift, standard flat fit, standard steep fit. And if you still feel it is not, you know, you can go for the next stage. There are four varieties of edge lifts are available for all the designs. Then there is another beauty of Roscale lens is ACT, asymmetrical corneal technology. If the cone is more steeper, you can see the, you know, there will be an, you know, the lower at 6 o'clock meridian, the lens will be little lifted like this. So what do you do? You can go for an ACT technology, asymmetrical corneal technology, where you can correct this. You can see here it is corrected. This lift here is corrected. How do you do this? The company has a special quadrant specific and allows the steepening of the cornea at that inferior quadrant. So then after that you assess the diameter. If you feel the lens is low riding, increase the diameter. So everything is separate: base curve, power, diameter, edge lift. Then after that, what you do the Bauer refraction, and if you still cylinder is there, you do a spherical equivalent refraction and then come to the final conclusion of the parameters. So like this, this gives you the base curve, this is the power of the lens, this gives you the diameter of the lens. This zero means is a standard edge lift. Depending on your fluorescein pattern, if it is tighter, you go for a standard flat. If it is a steeper, go for a standard flat. So if it is a flatter, go for a standard steep.